Hey, first of all, I want to say welcome, everybody. This is a wonderful gathering, a wonderful showing of all you folks out here. This is the Dancing with the Stars. Experience for the officially we call this the where is it here? The Glenwood Springs Chamber Resort Association. So that's it. So I had to get that part out, because if I didn't get that part out, then we'd be all in a lot of trouble. And I want to thank y'all for coming out here. This is going to be a wonderful night, and with me is Megan Walsh. Megan?
Thank you so much for being here, everyone. We're really excited. We're from News Channel 5.
Oh, I forgot that part. Yeah.
Area. In Grand Junction, you may know him. He's the chief meteorologist, and I am the...
I thought you were the chief meteorologist.
On the side.
Okay.
And I am the morning anchor, so it's past my bedtime. I'm here, out of my way. It's my bedtime at 5 p.m. So I'm excited to be here, and we're very happy and honored to be sharing the night with you.
Yeah, and we want to introduce one of the stars of the night tonight. And this star here is Michael McCallum. Now, he's the Vice President of Investment and Stifel. I hope I said that right. Steve, I practiced it three times. I said Stifel, I said don't say that because that's the lamp. So say it. Stifel, that's what I got to say. So I want to say Stifel Nicholas and Company, a chairman of the board of the Glenwood Springs Chamber Resort Association. Come on up, Mike.
Thank you. Welcome, everyone. We have a couple of our local elected officials here tonight. We'd like to welcome Ted Edmonds from City Council and Martin Neeson, our district attorney. It's always good to have one of them around for our events. Anyway, we've had an amazing year here at the Chamber, and there's so many people that we'd like to thank, and we've had so many accomplishments this year, starting with the Chamber Board of Directors, the staff, our amazing volunteers, many of whom are here tonight. The sponsors of tonight's events are the Glenwood Springs Ford, Bellevue Hospital, Alpine Bank, Glenwood Independent, Wells Fargo, Colorado Mountain College, the Bank of Colorado, Pinnacle Assurance, yes. Bill Slattery, HP Geotech, and Stifel Nicholas. Thanks also to the staff of the Hotel Colorado. I'd like to invite some of the other Chamber stars up to the stage. We're going to tell you about the year that was in 2 minutes flat, the fastest ever report in the history of the Chamber. So welcome, everyone. Thank you for coming.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Lindsay Lewis.
I'm Dylan Lewis.
And I was the Vice President of Tourism Marketing last year when the Chamber introduced Glenwood. We also had a visit from Bert the Conqueror from the Travel Channel. We were also named the most fun town in America by Rand McNally and USA Today.
I managed the social media marketing for the Glenwood Chamber. Last year, the Glenwood Chamber reached 5,000 friends and fans on Facebook and Twitter, and reached tens of thousands of people through glenwoodchamber.com and launched the Chamber app mobile application.
Yes.
Hi, I'm Mandy Murray of the Chamber Board, and I am proud to say that the Glenwood Chamber successfully hosted another Strawberry Days event that entertained 40,000 people, and they were able to recycle 46% of the discard at the Strawberry Days with the Green Strawberry Days initiative that they instituted this year.
Darren Cloud on the Chamber Board and the Roaring Fork Young Professionals, and the Chamber was able to connect many business people this year with the Bizopoly, the Chamber Business After Hours, and many leads, groups, and committees.
I'm Rolf Hermanson. This is my wife, Dina Hermanson. We met at a Chamber Business After Hours. I asked her to marry me 5 years ago tonight at a Chamber Ball. ambassadors and the chamber board, and Dina's in Lunch Bunch.
And the chamber represented 630 businesses and received a 95% approval rating from members in a recent survey.
That's a tough one to follow. I'm Angela Samples with Glenwood Insurance. I'm a member of the Business Women's Network and Take the Lead. I'm also the president this year of the Ambassadors. We just want to let you know that the Chamber represented our interests at a city hall and also hosted Governor Hickenlooper. And we also successfully engaged three business people to run for the city council and successfully win. Thanks.
Now I would like to introduce the former board chair of Dina Award recipient and 1998 Citizen of the Year, Tilly Fisher, to present this year's Citizen of the Year. We have more people before this. I'm sorry.
Hi, I'm Stan Jensen. I'm president of Colorado Mountain College, and this past year we have certainly strengthened our partnership with the chamber itself and with many, many businesses and organizations providing training, and look forward to an announcement about even stronger ties with the Chamber of Commerce in the very, very near future.
Hi, I'm Lisa Langer. I'm the new VP of Tourism Marketing, and I'm here with Glenn Wood. And we're just really happy for the Chamber's role in the economic stabilization of our tax receipts for 2011. You know, they do a lot to support business, and we're also very excited that the accommodations tax is up by nearly 8% this year. Very exciting. And my very favorite thing, we've just been named number 5 top ski town in America. So, hello, Glenwood Springs.
I'm Miriam Regilli, President and CEO of the Glenwood Springs Chamber, most fun town in America, and I have the greatest job in town. I'm so proud to represent our 630 members and thousands of employees in this community. I just wanted to say thank you to all our volunteers. I think we calculated over 7,000 volunteer hours contributed last year. And I wanted to especially thank two people here tonight that make everything run so smoothly. Before I get to that, I want to thank my entire staff, Joni Bates, Debbie Bannon, Angie Anderson, Lindsay Lewis just recently left our staff, Lisa Langer, who's new on board, Jan Smiley, April Walker, and also wanted to say a very special thank you tonight to Angie Anderson. She's the one behind the scenes that makes this event happen. She's very quiet. She does it very methodically. But if Angie, if you're out there, I have a little gift for you. Probably working somewhere, but the other person I want to thank is Mr. Michael McCallum, who is our corporate dad at the chamber. I mean, we cry on his shoulder. I talk to him probably 4 or 5 times a week. He is one of my best friends, and we have a little gift for Mike if you'd like to come up too.
Good evening. The Citizen of the Year is the highest award that is given by the Glenwood Springs Chamber Resort Association. It is given in memory of Dean H. Bogalar, who was our chamber manager from 1967 to 1974. The award is symbolic of his grand community support and his dedication. Tonight we have a few former recipients with us, and I wish they would stand, please, as we call their names. John Haynes. I know you're there, John. Carlton Hubbard, Jr., where are you, Hub? Hank Bosco. And myself. The broad criteria for this award is either a lifetime of service to the community or a one-time event of major proportions. The community as a whole is asked to nominate people for this award. These nominations are then turned over to the selection committee, and the selection committee, that is made up of former recipients, then selects someone from these nominations. The committee itself does not make nominations. This year's recipient is certainly an individual who will be honored for a lifetime of service and commitment to this community. He is also a business person who is widely known for his business acumen and success, but what is not known widely is all of the things that he has done for our community, and we're going to try and correct that this evening. He has been very generous with his time, with his leadership skills, with his abilities, and very generous financially in supporting many of the things here in Glenwood Springs. And he has done this in the areas of health and human services, the arts, education, and local government. Let's see the video that tells us more about this.
Old and vertically challenged.
A good person and a good guy.
But I can call him a friend, and I mean a true friend.
Genuine and giving.
Mom and Dad did like him better.
A man of great integrity and a man who lives his life with great passion.
We wouldn't be here without you.
This day and age we're living in gives cause for apprehension with speed and new invention and things like third dimension. Yet we get a trifle weary with Mr. Einstein's theory. So we must get down to earth at times, relax, relieve the tension. No matter what the progress or what may yet be proved, the simple facts of life are such they cannot be removed. You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things of life
has decided to come into into the valley and work with his dad in the petroleum business. That was many years ago. And as he was here working in that business, he kind of indicated on several occasions. I've heard the story a few different times. It started out that he was making $2.50 an hour. I think the last time I heard it was down to $2.15. So the working conditions were terrible. But his dad was a Texaco consignee.
Oh, we're the men of Texaco. We work from Maine to Mexico. There's nothing like the Texaco of Irish. Let's go united, powerful. We'll wow you with an hour full of pals from the shower full of stars. We're the merry Texaco men. Tonight we may be showmen.
And Consigny was basically a company that held all the Texaco accounts and delivered the product to Texaco. Texaco was in the midst of changing over to a distributorship, at which point Mike's dad was thinking it was time to kind of get out. And Mike decided that he was going to buy the business from his dad, and he did.
I wiped the pipe, I pumped the gas, I rubbed the hub, I scrubbed the glass, I set the clutch, I mop the top, I poke the choke, I sell a pop, I clear the gear, I pop the knock, I check the back, I set the box, so join the ranks of those who know, and fill your tank with Texaco.
Obviously, it wasn't easy times to begin with. He had to wear several hats. He was the driver, the bookkeeper, the secretary, also the janitor, even though back then it was just an outhouse outside of the hall plant. As the business started to grow, we brought on an individual, a nice young lady who he had working for him, and it was at, I think he was paying her about zero, so it was a little less than what he was making when he was working for his dad.
I did helped Michael with bookwork. He didn't pay me, and he fired me about four or five times. And so I didn't even need this. Find somebody else. And so at that point, then he did hire somebody else. Michael and I were a blind date, and Mrs. Fatter had two single boys. First date was the Knights of Columbus dance, and it was a wonderful evening. We had a lot of fun. We really enjoyed each other, and it wasn't too long after that I thought he was that special that he was the man I wanted to marry.
His nickname in high school and somewhat when he was here was Bats, but we actually had a lot of. I don't know, a lot of good memories of Mom and Dad. But Dad was very strict. He didn't, he towed the line. Both Mike and I worked at this boat plant. I'm upset that I found out that Mike got paid, because I don't remember getting paid. Dad had to pay for this, Mike. There's a lot of things that I don't know about Mike and I don't know about my dad, because they weren't very, they were not braggadocio. They always do things, Mike does, they do things on the sly. Dad was very active in the church. He helped put the money together to build what is now the Catholic school.
Hi, we're from St. Stephen's Catholic School. Thanks, Mr. Batter, for everything.
Well, when I first came here in 2003 to volunteer or to help out for about a year, the first person I met was Mike Fatter. And I quickly found out that this is a person that not only gave financial support to starting the school approximately 30 years ago, but he is a person that was very, very concerned about the children, concerned about the parents, and concerned about the bricks and mortar of the school. And I guess it's safe to say that he's been extremely supportive over the years. The minimal gesture that I can make is, Mike Fatter, you've been everything to St. Stephen's School. We wouldn't be here without you.
He was on the city council for 4 years, and the last 2 years of that, he was the mayor of Glenwood Springs. Michael was a very good mayor. He promoted the city very well. He was very active in it. He spent a lot of time working for the city in the fact of getting different things together and different things he promoted to promote the city and better its quality and its living. And he spent a lot of time doing this, and so therefore he spent time away from the family. So I would stand the kids in front of the door and I would say goodbye to your father, or these are your children.
Mike joined our board in 2005.
and being as energetic as he is. Mike has been our chair of the board for 2 years. He's our current chair of the finance committee. He's past chair of the quality committee. He's a member of our patient advisory council. You know, one thing about Mike, when he's involved in something, he's all in. He's 100%. So yeah, and I will say this, I want Mike to know this, I really do. Our hospital is so much better today than it was when Mike came on board in 2005. And it's really just a direct reflection of his hard work and his commitment, really is. I want to thank him for that. I think if I had a word to describe Mike, it would be generous. He's the most generous person I've ever been associated with. And it's not just financial. You know, he and Carol have done so much financially for the community down through the years. But when Mike gives his time, he gives himself to anything he's involved in. And, you know, I've said this many times, if a community had just a handful, maybe 8 or 10 people like Mike better, then everything would be all right. Because Mike just makes us better.
We have a lot of fun together. We laugh a lot. Michael's got a great sense of humor. I remember when Michael and I would work together when our gas truck was down. And so his other driver would deliver during the day and he would deliver at night. And so I would go with him at night. And we would deliver fuel up towards Gypsum. And about 2 or 3 in the morning, we'd be pitching pennies against the gas station, unloading fuel until we came back in and reloaded to take it out, take more fuel up. Michael loves to pheasant hunt. So before he got his hunting dog, I was the dog. We'd get out in the field and we'd point in one direction or the other direction and tell me which way to go to flush the birds up. Well, that didn't go very far. About that time, I said, it's time for you to get your own hunting dog.
I know there's probably some doctors that are out there in the audience tonight. If you are going to be doing any sort of a procedure on Mike Vatter, I strongly recommend that you are forewarned and you be very, very careful. Otherwise, you may end up with a message just like this.
Michael is an enigma. He is a man of integrity, of honesty, stands up firmly for what he believes in. He's a wonderful father. He loves his children. We've had a wonderful friendship. He's compassionate. He didn't misunderstand. And we've been very blessed. We've had a wonderful life together.
You know, when I look back at it, and I think probably what's means more to me than anything over the last few years of my relationship with Mike is that I can call him a friend. And I'm even a true friend. And, you know, I got to think about it. That's the same thing Glenwood Springs is like. You know, he loves this community. And because of Mike, it's a much better place to live.
Mike is a great guy. And what you see is what you get. He's been a wonderful brother. He's a wonderful person. He's one of the good guys. And it's a pleasure to be associated with him, by accident, to be associated with him. And he and Carol are great people. They've been great parents. They've been great for this community. And they've been great for our brother, my brothers. And he's a good representative of our family. So thanks, Mike. You've been great.
I would like to tell Michael how proud I am of him, how much I love him, and I admire him for everything he has done, and I'm very lucky, very happy, and very proud to be his wife. Thank you.
congratulations. I'd like to have you know that this apple did not fall very far from the tree. His father was the second ever Citizen of the Year, and Michael is the first child of a Citizen of the Year to be so honored. We are pleased to present Michael with this painting made by Mary Pylon, a local artist. It was selected at the Fall Arts Festival, and this is a depiction of the mural that Mary is going to be painting on the Anderson Building in commemoration of Glenwood's 125 years. And we have many family members who we'd like to acknowledge. Of course, there's the delightful Carol. Where are you, Carol? Three brothers, Joseph, Jim, and Terry. Where are you? And then there are the daughters, Stephanie and Katie. I think there's one. And there are two grandsons, Joseph and Patrick, and I bet you're here too. And don't they look like Mike? And we would also like to acknowledge his business partners, Gary Dean and Keith Popros, who are also here this evening.
Jesus, I don't know where to start. This is a total surprise. And probably my brother Terry probably said it best. We had two great parents. I have three great brothers. I have two great daughters, Stephanie and Katie. Katie is the youngest one who has kind of the warming, charming of her mother. Stephanie's a little fighter. She also brought to us two wonderful grandkids, Patrick and Joseph. Katie's husband is Chris. He served a tour in Iraq, and he was also a member of the Glenwood Springs Police Department. I hope I'm not losing my memory. If I'm saying anything wrong, I apologize. Stephanie's husband, Tim, is, as we're speaking, on his way to Afghanistan. He served a tour in Iraq also. And if you'll keep Tim in your prayers, we'd appreciate it. You're looking at a guy at the right place, right time. I mean, nothing I did special. I started a business when businesses weren't getting started. I had a guy by the name of Bob Young, who was starting a bank. I'm a guy who didn't have any money, but he needed cash in the bank, of which the business provided it and never got to me somehow, anyhow. But anyhow, so he gave me my first loan. I've had so many people that I work with that are personal friends of mine. Gene Yellowcoat, who's passed away. Again, I got to get back to my brothers because they are the foundation, basically, of the whole family, and I just could have followed along. But probably, truly, I've been blessed with a lot of partnerships that have been very successful. One with Gary Dean and Keith Bockross. They're from, one's from Grand Junction, the other's from Denver. And without those gentlemen, I wouldn't be where I am. And without Bob Young, I wouldn't be where I am. Without Gene Yellowcoat's help, etc. Guys by the name of Jim Rose, Papa. These are people who, through my life, gave me advice even when I wasn't asking for it. I was just listening for it. And they say things that stuck. And I appreciate it. But I gotta go to the person who made it all happen. And that's my wife, Carol, who really does have a wonderful heart, and she is a very strong woman. And I certainly appreciate all my other friends in this room, certainly the members of the hospital, Ken Kilrams, thank you very much for coming, I appreciate it, and all the members of the hospital, and just talking to the hospital, we are so blessed in this community to have this hospital. And it starts first with the administrations of Gary and Larry Duber, and then especially the doctors. We got 200 doctors working for us, and our board chair, Jeff Carlson, I believe, is here tonight. He puts all this together with Gary, and they have their little secret meetings, and somehow we always have a meeting a month, and everything works out. I don't know how that happens, but I certainly just want to take a second and say thank you very much for everything that everyone has done for myself and for my family, and I certainly appreciate it. Thank you.
Father Clint McMillan, went up to give the invocation. He is from St. Stephen's Church, pastor there. So come on up, give him a hug. Well, he makes his way up here. It was interesting. I was standing off to the side, and everybody out here, everybody's face was really lit up listening to that man talk. I never met that guy, but he certainly has influenced you guys very well. And it was a neat thing to watch from back here. Yes, sir.
Let us stand and give acknowledgement to our Lord Jesus Christ. All praise and honor and glory to you, most holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. This night we glorify you, we extol you, we laud you, we praise you. We recount the great gifts that you've given to us here in Glenwood Springs, especially the gift of Mike Fatter and his whole family. And all of his friends, we ask you, Lord, to raise up many more wonderful men and women for this community that will draw us closer to you through their exercise of generosity in both time, talent, and treasure. We ask you, Lord, to help us to do your will. And this night, as we are gathered for this wonderful banquet on this magnificent occasion, may this occasion be an instrument of your salvation in our lives. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon all of us and remain with us forever.